Genetically engineered medicine is when scientists rewrite an organism's genetic instructions and it gives it properties that it wouldn't usually have. Scientists are trying to use these methods in the field of medicine and change the way we look at things today. Some pros of this technology include a microorganism producing insulin for people with diabetes. Using this, diabetes could be cured if we could change that person's genes with the microorganisms. The protein that is being exchanged is also considered a magic bullet that combats the body's inability to regulate itself. Dwarfism, a genetic defect in which people are abnormally small, could be treated by someone being donated something called human growth hormone. This has been tested on mice and has shown good results. This technology can also be used in things called piggyback vaccines or subunit vaccines. These are used to fight viruses that cause herpes and hepatitis. One of the cons that this new technology has is manufacturing the proteins. The proteins needed for this technology cannot be donated freely because it is in a low supply in a normal human free of defects. This makes it expensive to obtain and hard to find, but there's a solution. The proteins needed are grown in bacteria, and since the bacteria is cheap, it makes the proteins cheap and easy to make, resolving the problem. This method is being used around many pharmacies and will be a major advancement in technology. There are many ethical issues involving this technology, and here are some of them. We don't know if this is a safe enough treatment to put out to the public. We also don't know the long-term effects of replacing someone's genes. Will this change and redefine the term normal? You could be normal and still have minor defects, but with this technology, normal would have to be the perfect version of yourself. And don't forget about the issues with testing these things on animals. Even with these issues and risks, this technology could better or even save some people's lives. And you know what they say, life is full of risks.
Hello, and thank you for watching Science 360 Genetic Engineering. Today we are going to talk about genetic engineering and how it is helping us fight the disease diabetes. There are two types of diabetes. The process that we'll discuss today is important for both types, type 1 and type 2. But we'll spend most of our time talking about type 1 diabetes. This is sometimes called childhood diabetes. In childhood diabetes, something goes wrong with the immune system. Our immune system is sort of like a police force for our body. Whenever something dangerous, like a virus, comes in, our immune system kicks in and protects the body. But in childhood diabetes, the immune system gets the wrong guy. When someone has childhood diabetes, their immune system attacks the cell in their own pancreas. These cells are very important because they produce a molecule called insulin. When a diabetic person's body stops producing insulin, they become very sick. If they don't receive treatment, they could die. Fortunately, doctors can give diabetic patients new insulin to inject into themselves. If they receive insulin regularly, then people with childhood diabetes can live fairly normal lives. So what does any of this have to do with genetic engineering? Well, when doctors first began using insulin, they had to get it from cows, along with some other farm animals. But insulin was hard to get from animals. First, the animal had to be slaughtered. Then its pancreas was removed. A scientist could extract a little bit of insulin from this organ. We needed a better way to get insulin, and genetic engineering provided one.